There is something about the ice.
There we go.
That calls to Dennis Borland.
All you, got time.
The sound of the rink and the rush of adrenaline as the puck closes in on his spot in goal. It's a need for speed that drew Borland to another hobby and to a 2019 morning he'll never forget.
The two things outside of family that I really enjoy doing, riding a motorcycle, playing hockey. So that morning, jumped on my motorcycle, was riding home. I got almost home. A guy in a Jeep was going west. He decided he wanted to go south, and he turned directly into me.
Borland was thrown 70 feet, skidding to a halt on Highway 60.
I do remember when it happened, thinking, it's time to wake up. I need to wake up. This needs to be over. I need to wake up. And I didn't wake up.
He was taken to UC Health Medical Center of the Rockies, where doctors fought to save his life.
And everyone saved my life that day. I mean, the guy that put the tourniquet on, he saved my life. The surgeons, they saved my life. I mean, all these people. And then the other people that you don't hear about saving your life are the people that gave blood before my accident that saved my life as well.
Borland needed more than 7 units, quite a lot, considering the human body only holds about 10.
So this is where we collect a majority of our blood products.
Thankfully, the Garth England Blood Center had plenty to spare.
Some of our trauma situations that the hospital see could use 10, 20, 30 units, and that is 10, 20, or 30 visits from various donors throughout the community.
But other blood banks have not been so fortunate. Anna Johnson says that's left some hospitals short on supply.
We're really trying not to let it get to a point where we have to make tough decisions.
Borland is hoping his story can convince others to donate.
And you never know who you're going to save. It could be your hockey buddy. It could be your baseball buddy. It could be just your friend.
And while Borland is fortunate to be alive, his road back to the rink has not been easy.
And they amputated below the knee. So I have a BK, below the knee amputation.
Borland is now learning to play the game he loves with just one leg.
I can't change anything that happened a minute ago. The only thing I can change is something that's going to happen a minute from now.
Today, that involves stopping another shot. Tomorrow, who knows?
You just have to move forward.
A road to recovery. Borland is simply thankful to be on. In Loveland.
Oh, thanks for giving me a couple minutes.
Evan Krugel.
Have a good one.
Fox 31.